usually you don't see those kind of long practices at this juncture of the season, but when you have an 11-day break, like you said, you got to shake that rust off, and there's a good clean win off the opening draw, so a quick start.
Dion picks it up. After the CU trying to steal it back. He does. He's on the move. Driving to the net. Hellebuck was there. Morrissey has it. We've had an extended amount of time to start off this game without a whistle. Potential 2-on-1. Here it is. Scheifele's in. Pass blocked. He gets it back. Mrazek the save. Pass in front from Wheeler. And the Jets can't capitalize. Here's Connor Murphy. Long range pass, as you mentioned, Gary. Max Domi looking for it. It wasn't available. 3-on-2 for Winnipeg. Dubois shoots. It's off the mask of Mrazek and play whistled down. To this fourth matchup between the Jets and the Blackhawks on Hockey Night in Canada. Gary, I believe you followed that game.
Binnington was outstanding in that game. I thought the Jets had outplayed them, outchanced them, had got a lot of quality scoring chances, but they couldn't beat Binnington.
Morrissey trying to play the puck forward. Boris Kachuk has it. Slap shot from Jack Johnson and end whistle right near the net. That's Reese Johnson, pardon me.
He didn't have it. We'll have another look at it when we get back, but I don't think he had it either.
Given the region says teams will know 7 to 10 days before the deadline what their decisions are. Hunter Ryan and Gary with the call of the second.
Those are really the first comments he's made regarding his availability.
Saying that New York was a team that he was looking at after the Rangers completed the trade to acquire Vladimir Tarasenko. Here's Josh Morrissey on the move. Backhand shot, and he scores! There's no stopping Josh Morrissey this season. The Jets are up 1-0.
Lowry gets it around the wall. Kuhlman gets knocked off by Jones. Dickinson, soft play up the wall. Soft plays in your boards, up your walls, will come back to haunt you. Morrissey pinches in. He's got good support down the middle of the ice for him up high, so he's allowed to do that. Look at the coverage on the backside right there by Lowry, who started to play off around the wall.
Face-off prowess for the Blackhawks. Not in the lineup tonight, as mentioned by Scott Oak. Here's Patrick Kane. Great pass, great save, and another one by Hellebuck as he denies the Blackhawks here on the power play thus far. Scheifele over to Kyle Connor. We haven't seen a shot from him yet. Here's Dubois shooting. Mrazek was there. Connor back to Morrissey. Scheifele, one-timer blocked by Connor Murphy. Scheifele to Morrissey. Kyle Connor, now he shoots, and again, another shot off of Mrazek's mask as he yanks it off. Kyle Connor has a look. Connor to the point. Morrissey back to Connor. Moving up. Wrist shot. Mrazek got enough. Puck kicked in by Morrissey. Josh Morrissey over to Kyle Connor. Passing tight. Wheeler tried to give it back. Jets forced to the outside. Wheeler moving up. He connects with Scheifele, but it was a hard pass to take care of. Morrissey. Connor shoots. They score! Tipped home by Blake Wheeler. The Jets are up by two.
Give the puck unselfishly to somebody else. But here, you got to give the Jets credit. They've kept the puck in the zone the whole time. They haven't had to go down the ice to get it. And eventually, they put a puck into someone's wheelhouse. Kevin Bieksa talked about the sloppy passing. I think we continue to see it on this power play. They're going through the seams, but the puck's not in the wheelhouse. There you go. You had to get involved.
Here's Kyle Connor driving to the net. Nice deke, but Mrazek was able to hold his ground, and he hangs on. Kyle Connor on the hunt for his 25th of the season here in Winnipeg. Prevented from doing so. Dickinson has it. Lost it to Scheifele. He was pushed off by Morrissey. Ehlers to Pion. Wheeler. Scheifele scores! The one-timer from Mark Scheifele puts the Jets up by three.
They come up the ice. Nice job by Scheifele to Wheeler. Cross pass to Ehlers as he throws it into the middle of Pionk. He misses him. So he misses his intended target. But where does it land? Onto the stick of Wheeler. And he dials this right into the correct spot.
He's going to hang around with us a little bit later on for after hours.
You mean after hours.
After hours, yeah.
Here's Hellebuck shutting the door on Tyler Johnson.
Awful slow tonight, too. She was really drawing it out, so I thought that was going to make us even later.
She was enjoying the moment,
she was,
Monica.
As we look at Tyler Johnson, getting way back on track.
Domi to Radish. He shoots. And did that come awful close or what? Here's Hellebuck shutting the door this time. Let's take another look at this, Gary.
No problem, little hand tap. Here's the shot, hits him in the glove, and I think it kind of rattles off his elbow a little bit. Glove and the inner elbow, and then it drops behind him. He's getting some accolades that are league-wide that his teammates have known for a long time, and they respect him immensely, and they're glad to see him. And the rest of they're glad to see the rest of the league.
Second most game-winning goals as a defenseman this season, and he started it off tonight, so we'll see if he can add to that. Morrissey out there now swimming for the puck as he was knocked down. Dickinson to the point. Jake McCabe, wrister right in the blue paint, and capitalizing is Tyler Johnson as the Chicago Blackhawks are alive.
A battle down low with Kane. Kane pokes the puck away from him, and Dickinson comes around the net, picks it up, throws it to the point, and here's the shot. And Pionk, just as he's trying to box out Johnson, Tyler Johnson, he gets inside position on him, and the rebound squirts to the fortuitous side. It squirts to the forehand of Johnson, and he's able to pick it up. Morrissey steps up on Kane, goes to lift his stick. I'm not sure if Kane deflected that puck or not, which made it hard for Hellebuck.
Tyler Johnson's sixth of the season. Patalainen shooting in tight. Mrazek standing his ground.
And they played a pretty good spirited game in their last game played against St. Louis. So as a coaching staff, you feel like maybe it's coming back around.
And here we go. The runway is open for Stedlin. It's Mrazek with the right pad stop. Kane waiting. Flips it to Tyler Johnson. Back to Seth Jones. Johnson. Pass to the corner. Domi is there. Radish centering pass. Trying to jam it home was Patrick Kane. And it's Connor Hellebuck.
Losing that 4 or 5 foot, 10 foot pass. The defensive guys are all going to follow. They're just going to follow the puck moving around. But when you skip a pass, when you go over one person to another person, then the shift is you got to move more guys in more places, then it opens up.
Winnipeg forcing the puck out, 40 seconds. Chance for Wheeler, Lowry, empty net, off the iron. Back in front, Morgan Barron shoots, he missed. Half a minute to go. Barron, out front, Wheeler scores.
We saw Wheeler laughing on the last goal, the Scheifele goal. He's getting a chuckle on this one, too. He gives it to Lowry, who misses it, hits the side of the post. Barron misses a wide-open net, and then it's Barron.
In Winnipeg, final score 4-1. The Winnipeg Jets have defeated the Chicago Blackhawks.